Everybody is half dead. Everybody avoids everybody. All over the place, in most situations, most all of the time. I know I'm one of those everybodies. And to me, it is terrible. And so all I'm trying to do all the time is just to open people up so they can feel themselves and let themselves be open to somebody else. That is all. That's it.
I've always thought that I was shaking people up, but now I want to go at it more, and I want to go at it more deliberately, and I want to go at it coldly. I want to shake people up so bad that when they leave a nightclub where I performed, I just want them to be to pieces. I want to go in that den of those elegant people with their old ideas, smugness, and just drive them insane.
When I'm calm and cool and really got the antenna working, you know when to push and you know when not. Nobody can tell you, though. You have to feel it. In any situation between human beings, it's what makes a groove.
Well, what's free to you mean?
What's free to me? Yeah. Same thing it is to you. You tell me.
No, you tell me. No. Because I've been talking for such a long
time. It's just a feeling. It's just a feeling. It's like, how do you tell somebody how it feels to be in love? How are you going to tell anybody who has not been in love how it feels to be in love? You cannot do it to save your life. You can describe things, but you can't tell them. But you know it when it happens. That's what I mean by free. I've had a couple of times on stage when I really felt free. And that's something else. That's really something else. Like, I'll tell you what freedom is to me. No fear. I mean, really, no fear. If I could have that,
Oh, yeah. My hips invite you.
There's a prejudice that at one time was against homosexuals.
At one time?
Yeah, hold on. When it was a criminal offense, even. Mm-hmm. Then that's got removed.
The law.
And people started to appear to accept. Mm-hmm. Back, it comes again now because of AIDS.
It never went anywhere. People's attitudes don't change because the law changes. I know that. And the homosexual questions like this, like, it's like what we call the racial question. Nobody, no man and no woman, is precisely what they think they are. Love is where you find it. And you don't know where it will carry you. And it is a terrifying thing, love. It is the only human possibility, but it's terrifying. And a man can fall in love with a man, a woman can fall in love with a woman. There's nothing anybody can do about it. It's not in the province of the law. It's something you do with the church. And if you lie about that, you lie about everything. And no one has a right to try to tell another human being whom he or she can or should love.
But when you wrote Giovanni's Room a long time ago, that was quite a brave book to bring out, wasn't it? It was about love, but it was about homosexual love, but it was about love. But you deliberately put in homosexual love, presumably.
Well, the boy's in the middle. It's not so much about homosexuality at all. It's about what happens to you if you can't love anybody. It doesn't make any difference whether you can't love a woman, you can't love a man, if you can't love anybody, you're dangerous. Because you have no way of learning humility. No way of learning that other people suffer. And no way of learning how to use your suffering and theirs to get from one place to another. In short, you fail even responsibility, which is to love each other.
Love me in the winter when it's it's bitter, bitterly cold. Love me in the summer when gorgeous girls are running wild. Love me in the autumn when the colors start to change. Love me in the springtime when it all starts again. It starts again. It starts again. We break up, kiss, make up, and it starts again. Oh, starts again. Oh, starts again. Can't pretend to love another, so we start again. Love me when I hurt you, though I never mean to. It comes to pass. Love me when I'm silent and all you want is reassurance. Yes. Love me when I'm too loud and constantly repeat myself. Oh, love me when I'm angry and say I never wanted to see your face again. So we start again. Start again. Can't pretend to love another, so we start again. Start again. Oh, start again. Can't pretend to love another, so we start again. But I don't wanna start again. Start again. Just to make up and break up, we start again. Start again. Oh, start again. Can't pretend to love another, so we start again. But whatever we need, we need. And for your love, I am such a fool. When I say that I don't want you, I've become the boy who cried out wolf.
As women, we need to examine the ways in which our world can be truly different. I am speaking here of the necessity for reassessing the very quality of all the aspects of our lives and of our work. The very word erotic comes from the Greek word eros, the personification of love in all its aspects, born of chaos and personifying creative power and harmony. When I speak of the erotic, then, I speak of it as an assertion of the life force of all women, of that creative energy empowered, the knowledge and use of which we are now reclaiming in our language, our history, our dancing, our loving, our work, our lives.
Don't hold your breath.
don't hold it, don't hold your breath. Don't hold your breath, don't hold it, don't hold your breath, don't hold it, don't hold your breath, don't hold it, don't hold your breath.
The last thing you want to be is just well adjusted to injustice. That's the last thing you want to be. The last thing you want to be. Well adjusted to I'm just fitting in. Well adapted to indifference. Rabbi Heschel used to say, indifference to evil is more insidious than evil itself. He's right about that. William James used to say, indifference is the one trait that makes the very angels weep. And that callousness, that coldness, that numbness is what is reinforcing the worst of our collective project together.
Just because I cannot see doesn't mean I don't believe. Tell you I can feel it. Can you see the wind as it blows without sight? The leaves dance, even though I sometimes stray. You remain closer than you've ever been. I can hear the wind as it blows on my face. Yes, I know in everything. I can't see it in everything. But I can feel it in every step. In every step, oh, even though I struggle to follow through, break down and cry, I know you catch my every tear. I can feel the wind as it blows on my face. Yes, I know that just because I cannot see doesn't mean I don't believe. Tell you I can feel it. I can feel the wind as it blows without sight. The leaves dance in everything. I can't see it in everything. In every step, said in every step, in every step. It won't stop your touch, no.
You won't make
you in heaven. Cause I don't like the life that you live. Oh, won't you promise me? Don't you lose. Don't you lose.